Hello there, this is Ahobiram and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time, you're welcome. And if you are a returning subscriber, you already know how it is. Thank you for coming back again to see another video. So guys, it has been a long time since I sat down in front of the camera and did like a proper video because we've been out there vlogging, going to different cities and all of that. So today I decided to sit down and talk about some things here on the channel with you guys. So I've been getting questions, or I have gotten so many questions in the past, and I know that I will continue to get these questions in the future. So I decided to put out this video about, okay, someone wants to apply to a certain university. They are quite unsure, should I apply to this or should I apply to that? And you're asking me to choose or to recommend universities for you. So guys, I decided to bring up certain things you need to consider when you are choosing a university abroad, wherever this particular video is applicable to any country in the world. If you have to choose a university education, these are the things that you need to consider before you choose a university. So without talking too much, let's jump into the gist for today. So now, the very first thing I'll be talking about, the very first thing to consider is, what do you want? Yes, what exactly do you want? What course of study, what field of study do you want to go into? So you first of all need to identify the area that you want to further your career in or start a career in order to be able to choose a university. So that way, when you're looking at universities, you know to filter out, okay, I'm looking to do a bachelor's or a master's or a PhD in a particular course of study, then you can now look for a university that has that course of study. So that's the first tip. So what do you want to study? Are you interested in business, management, engineering, architecture? What exactly do you want to do? Because if you do not have a direction, then you would just dabble around and pick any university. The next thing I would also like to say is, now for someone who wants to do a master's, I totally understand that you might probably have done a bachelor's degree in a different field of studies and then you worked in a different field of study and then you don't know if you should move between your current job or your previous school that you went through and you're just confused. So in that case, there are other things to look out for. There are other options to weigh. So that brings me to the second thing that we're going to be looking at. Now, when we finally identify that, okay, I want this particular course, the next thing is to sieve out the universities that are offering this particular course. Now, in order to choose the best universities, of course, you need to resort to going to check the ratings of these universities. Now, what are the qualities of these universities? How is this university ranked in that particular university? So let's bring it down to Poland. So now in Poland, I've talked about it in a different video. Poland has its universities clustered or grouped by the specialty. So we have technical universities, we have medical universities, we have normal universities for arts and business, we have universities of economics, life sciences, and all of that. So all the universities are broken part by part. So if you've identified that you want to go into management, then you would look at the economics and business universities and try to choose, okay, what is the rating of this university and all of that. So the rating is very important. I took out time to go through to find an article that talked about the ratings of most universities in Poland. I have an exhaustive list. I will pop it on the screen for different fields of study so you could see like the top three best universities. So if you are looking for quality over whatever factor, you would be looking into the top three universities in a particular field of studies. So yeah, you check the rating and then you would know that, okay, this university seems like a very good university academically and I would love to apply here. So that is a second factor to consider. The next factor to consider is the course content and the course that you want to study. So we've identified, for example, we've taken, okay, I want to study engineering, and then you've seen the top three technical universities in Poland. Now you would go through the three universities, or even four or five, it depends on you, and then you check what, if these universities offer the course that you have chosen and what the course content is like. Now, every university has different modules and different modules for a particular course. So you would want to look into the modules and see what this course is offering you. This way, it would help you to streamline your choice. You'd know that, okay, this particular course is giving me more of a technical feel of things than this other course and all of that. You'll be able to weigh and know which university has the better module for you. Now, the next thing to consider is the cost of studies and the facilities and all of that. So I'm just going to put it as others. So you would consider the cost. So how much is the tuition? How much are you going to pay for this university and all of that? So some people would prioritize cost over quality, while some other people would prioritize quality over the cost. So it all depends on you, what your budget is. So you would also need to make a budget for your schooling so that if you get an admission, you would know how to fund it. I keep saying this in my previous videos that when you're coming to school in Poland, for example, of course you can work and pay your tuition at some point, but it's very difficult, but it's very good for you to have a backup. So if, for example, your tuition is a certain amount of money, you should know that, okay, have a backup plan just in case you're not able to get something that would be sustainable to be able to pay your fees. So how is the cost like? What is the location of the city? So now, city plays a very big role, or the location of a school plays a very big role in you coming, like in the choice you're making. Yeah, I know a lot of people tend to overlook this, but you need to look at the city you're going to. Now, what are the job availabilities in that city? How are, like, what is it like in that city? You need to know what is going on in that city before you choose to move to that city. The next thing you should also consider in the university is, if you're someone who is into sports or other social activities, what are the sports and social activities like in that university? Another one to consider is the exchange programs and sponsorship and partnerships that this university has with other international universities. So it's important to also check this, because in Poland here, there is something called Erasmus. So you could do like an exchange program, and most universities offer this with some other, like they partner with other schools where they have an exchange. So you would leave your country for maybe two semesters, one semester to a different country for an exchange program. So you need to also find out what the exchange program is like, what countries, what universities they have collaborations with and all of that. So this is very important as well, because you're not just coming to school just for the academic side of things. You're also coming for to become a full rounded individual. So both academics and socially, you are also fully involved in both aspects. So yeah, these things are important as well. The next one is, I touched on it a little bit earlier. The next one is the job availability. Now, this is not job availability in the city alone, but job availability when it comes to the course that you have chosen. So let's take it that I have chosen to do a particular course, say management or business administration, in a particular university. Now, you need to find out what are the career path, or what is the career path, and what are the jobs that are available for me when I graduate from graduate from that course. So if I graduate as a master's student or a master's degree holder in business administration, what are the possible jobs to do with this degree? One thing you need to look for, which helped me in my case, was what I did was, you go to LinkedIn. LinkedIn is the job platform, if you don't know. So you would go to LinkedIn and try to just type in your university and then put alumni. So in this example, let's say I put Warsaw University of Technology, or University of Technology Warsaw alumni. So you would go search this, and you would see that there is a long list of people. Now, I'm not asking you to do this for any reason. I'm just asking you to do this so you would see the kind of jobs that people from this university have transitioned into. Like, you would meet so many people, not meet them per se, but you would see so many people's profiles, and you would get to see the jobs, the different companies. You can even filter it to check what companies these alumni work with. So it gives you a sense of direction that, okay, people from the university that I'm interested in have this particular pathway when it comes to their career. So you're not just moving into a university that you don't know what is going on. You're also seeing that people who have graduated from this university that you're about to go into have also made like some successive moves in their career, or they have made like very great moves in their career. So this would help you to know that, okay, I'm going in the right direction. So this is something that you should also look to. So now back to the job availability as well. So when you're on that LinkedIn and looking around and seeing the job profession that people have moved into, you could also take a step further to look at people who went out from your university, studied the course you're about to study, and the career path that they went through. Now these career pathways would help you to have a sense of understanding of your own career. Now I totally understand, I'm a young person as well who has been, over the years, I've been trying to figure out my career path. What exactly am I interested in? What job do I want to do? All of that is something that I have dealt with personally, and I'm sure you probably have at one point in your life, or you're currently dealing with it. So when you look at other people who study the same thing with you, you see the skills they have, you see the progressions that they have made. So when you've seen this, it would give you more information, and you can see the possibilities that your course can actually take you to, because we're in 2021, there are so many job roles. You probably do not know that the course that you have studied somehow has a relationship with a different kind of job that you have never heard or never come in contact with. And how can you know if you do not find out? So if you see people who have graduated from your field, you look at the skills, then you know what you're doing. So now going back to the course module, let's take it that you're a finance person and you're applying for finance and accounting. Now if you have done what I've said to do, you've looked, seen graduates of that university that are working in financial institutions, and you've seen their skills and all of that, now you would be able to know that, okay, as I'm studying finance and accounting, these are key skills that I should be gaining while I'm doing my master's or while I'm doing my bachelor. So as you're gaining the experience from school, you're also developing your skills in that field of study for the future use. Now I'm going to make another video, like I'm going to make series of this kind of video about your career path, how to figure it out, saving, budgeting and all of that in other videos. So just stay tuned for those videos. I promise they are going to be very, you don't want to miss it. They are going to be very, very, let me not brag about it until the videos come out, okay? So yeah, so after doing these searches, the next thing, you can go on Google or you can go on go-poland.pl to find universities. It's very simple. You filter out the university, the course, and all of that. It gives you a whole range of universities. So you don't just have to rely on the top three that I have mentioned. You can just go and keep finding. You can find on Google, you can find on this website, and you can even find from talking to people and different recommendations. So yeah, I know some of you have probably chosen some universities while some others are still indecisive on where to go, or you're still making plans for future, like for maybe not right now, maybe for the next semester or the next session, and it's fine. So this video is out there for you guys. So there is also this website that you can apply to some universities from. So I had talked about some universities in the past, WSG University. They are still open for admissions, because I think a lot of people also have asked if some schools, when are they closing and all of that. So they are still open for admissions. You can go to studyineurope.pl. So I will put the link as well in the description. So studyineurope.pl, you could apply for some universities. So if you're looking to do nursing in English, you could also go there to select WSG University for nursing. And there are other courses as well. Apart from gopoland.pl, you can also check out that website to apply to some schools and some courses. So with all these things in mind, you would be able to pick the right school. Now, let me give you a brief story. So when I was coming to Poland, I had to meet up with my uncle, and he made me do something which at the time I thought was difficult. But looking back now, I see the reason why I did that assignment that he gave to me. So I met him and I told him I was interested in doing my master's and all of that. And he told me to do a five-year plan. Guys, a five-year plan. He wanted me to write out what I would be doing in 5 years. So first of all, from the universities, I should break down my universities, the choices I want talk about the career progression, the job availability, like just give a holistic understanding of what you think moving to Poland will be for you in 5 years. Yes, I did that. I still have that document because I had it. I took my time. I did a presentation before they allowed me come to Poland. So guys, so yeah, what I did was, yeah, I followed these steps that I have just said. I had researched 3 top universities in Poland. I had gone on LinkedIn. I had tracked down their graduates. I had seen the courses that they were, I had seen the jobs that they were doing. I had seen the skills that were required for the jobs that they were doing. I had compared salary. Yes, I had compared salary rating, like how much a graduate of my faculty doing a particular job will be earning. And this was from Glassdoor. So you can go to Glassdoor and check. So I had done all of this. I presented it. So I had 3 schools. I had the costs. Yeah. So I had like a proper documentation stating these are 3 universities. These 3 universities, this is course option A. This is course option B. This is course option C. These are the modules. This is the school fee that is required. This is the city and all of that. So I was looking into Warsaw University of Technology, Wrocław University of Technology, and Poznań University of Technology. And Wrocław University of Technology won my heart. That is where I am. That is my school. I rep that university so much. So yeah. So at the end of the day, that was what I went for. So I had done this presentation, arranged everything according to what I'll be doing. The next thing I did was to look for companies. I had to look for companies in those 3 cities. So companies that it was possible for me to work as a graduate of Applied Advanced Electronics. So I had to look for companies as well. I also had to explain career progression. I don't want to go too deep into that whole presentation that I did with my uncle. But yeah, I did this presentation and I showed it to him and he was impressed. And he was like, okay, you seem to have an idea about what 5 years from now would look like. And now looking back at it, like, I'm so thankful that he put me through that exercise because it kind of opened my eyes and it helped me to make the right choices when it comes to my career path and career progression. I'm not there yet, but I'm headed in a direction that I'm like, I really did not see it coming. Okay, let me not say I didn't see it coming per se, but I'm headed in the right direction, if you get what I mean. So that's what I'm saying. Just choosing a right university alone, just something as little as this, can help you in your career progression. So guys, this is the summary of all this talk I've been talking about. This is the end of the video, or this is everything. Like I said in the previous videos, I would be helping you or talking about navigating your career path, budgeting, money, like all those interesting conversations to help you build your life here in Poland or in any other European country. But of course, I live in Poland, so most of my explanations and everything are from a perspective of someone who is in Poland. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up. Do not forget to subscribe. Guys, we are almost on 10k. So we are almost on 10k subscribers. Do not forget to like, do not forget to share, do not forget to comment down below. And do not forget, guys, we are open, because it's our channel, we are open for video recommendations. Guys, leave your thoughts, comments in the description. I'll put the links for everything I've said, so the ratings of the university, the where to find the universities, I'll put the links in the description box. And guys, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.